As you can see, there's plenty of buzz on the road. Traffic, people. It seems to be a typical Saturday evening. That was a very different Bengaluru. Mid-90s, late-90s. A sleepy city it was, but then when it came to the evening scene, certainly was quite vibrant.
So vade is gone for the second dip, for the second dip in that hot oil. And that ensures the vade is crunchy. You know, you can make out by the sound that the vade makes when it hits that chadai.
So the vade is half in size, but then who cares if the taste of the vade is special. Hi folks, hope you're doing well. It's a Saturday evening and I've stepped out for a short city ride. As you can see, there's plenty of buzz on the road. Traffic, people. It seems to be a typical Saturday evening. So this evening, I'm headed to an area called Vignan Nagar here in Bengaluru. Vignan means science and Nagar is locality. So this area is named so because all the science-based organizations are in and around the area. Whether it's HAL, I think ISRO too. And so all the people who work there, I guess scientists, engineers, academicians, so all the people who have science in their DNA live in that area, so that's why the name Vignan Nagar. So what am I going to Vignan Nagar for? Well, for one, the plan is to do a short city ride. Vignan Nagar is roughly about 13 kilometers from home, so you know, you get about 30 kilometers, about 40 minutes each way. Of course, plenty of traffic lights along the way. Not the most ideal, but hey, at least you're out on a ride. You watch me? So that kid watches me on YouTube. So the plan is to ride out to Vignan Nagar for a short city ride. And also, I'm going to be visiting a place called Ayyar Idli. Now, Ayyar Idli is a tiny eatery that's been around for nearly two decades, if my memory serves me well. And I did an episode on Ayyar Idli a few months ago. This place is run by a mother-son duo. They used to sell somewhere in the region of about 50,000 idlis each month. And now, of late, they've also begun selling vades. So they had messaged me a while ago, asked me to come over and taste their vades. So I've had this at the back of my mind. And today, this short city ride seems to be the perfect opportunity to head to Ayyar Idli and make an early supper of the vade there. And of course, whilst I'm there, I'm surely gonna try the idli too. Plenty of traffic, plenty of traffic. And there's some water crossing too. Not the most ideal when you're crawling, because you'll get splashed. Oops, I think we managed the splash. Anyways, so yes, so the plan is to go to Vignan Nagar, a locality of engineers, scientists, and taste some idli vade. So stick around, hopefully this should be interesting. Very sweet of that kid to wave out, mentioning that he watches the show. It's amazing how people now recognize the motorcycles. They recognize the fat boy as is, but I think the Himalayan too now, I think the panniers that I always have on are quite distinct, as you can see in the mirror. And perhaps the helmet too. I don't think there are too many people who ride around with a shark helmet. That's the brand of the helmet. It's a French helmet. And of course, I think the GoPro mounted onto the helmet, I think seals it. So when they spot a motorcyclist on a Himalayan with a GoPro, with the panniers, waving, talking to himself seemingly, I guess they figure this could be gourmet on the road. So that was the road to go to the old airport. Yeah, so that's it, HAL airport. I don't know if you can see that. So the old airport is owned by HAL, Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. And that was the old airport. Very, very tiny as opposed to what we have now. Evenings would be a mess and mornings too, but then one found a way to make it work. In fact, the old airport road also was a scene of a couple of bars, if I'm not mistaken. I don't know how many of you remember, there used to be a club there called Concord, way, way back. And I think one of the earliest bowling alleys too, I think it was called Mega Ball, if I'm not mistaken, came up right next to the old airport, right next to the airport. I mean, it was the airport then. There was no concept of old airport. That was a very different Bengaluru. Mid-90s, late-90s. You may find it hard to believe, but a sleepy city it was. But then when it came to the evening scene, certainly was quite vibrant. Seven minutes away from Ayyar Idli. So these are all the science-based organizations, Aeronautical Development Company. We passed HAL. The one thing that you realize when you do these short city rides is that each locality has its own persona or character, so to speak. In terms of what you find there, in terms of the people, the establishments, etc. Avan Rehmat Biryani. Ah, I can smell some good food. I don't know if it's from the biryani shop or somewhere else. Mudde Mane. Cow Bar. That's an interesting name. Okay, I think we are somewhere in that area. I'm not quite sure where Ayyar Idli is. Oh, it says I've passed Ayyar Idli. Do you know where's Ayyar Idli?
Ayyar Idli?
Yeah. Yeah. My GoPro is on.
That's okay.
That's okay.
I'm sorry.
Hi.
Hi. You have to go over here.
Ali,
cake and corner.
Cake and corner.
Left.
Ali left.
Cake and corner. Left.
Okay.
Left side is Ayyar Idli. Right side
is Ayyar Idli. Munche bande the, but I just seemed.
Okay, you missed, I think, sir.
Seemed to miss it. What are your names?
My name is Soumya.
Soumya.
Nagendra.
Nagendra. You guys live in this area?
Yeah, yeah. Yes. We live in this area.
And we watched all your videos, a lot of videos.
Yeah? You watched Ayyar Idli?
Yeah, we watched Ayyar Idli.
So they've got vade now, right?
Yeah, now he's making vade out. Yeah.
So I was out for a city ride, I said, let me eat some vade today.
Equally good.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's equally good.
Okay. Let's find out. See you. Yeah. Nice meeting you. Bye. I'm baking in my riding jacket. I'm always in my riding gear. Oh, I think this is where it is. If I'm not mistaken. Yes. I'm here at Ayyar Idli. They open only in the morning for I think 2 or 3 hours till the idlis run out, and similarly in the evening, I think from 6 onwards. I've come here on a short city ride here to Ayyar Idli, and I'm standing here with Krishan, and of course it's him and his mom. Is the mom around here?
Mom's retired now, so she's at home. She's taking retirement now.
So you're running it?
I'm running it now, yeah.
Fantastic. So Ayyar Idli has a new sign. Looks nice and bright. And that's not the only new thing here, also the vade.
The vada, yeah.
So how did the vade happen now?
So it was a very, very tough decision to make. I've been pondering over it for the last 6 months. I had a corporate job back then, and I mean, after obviously after your first episode, our customer base grew, you know, large in bounds. We had new people coming in from different parts of the city. We've had people visiting us from other states. The first question everyone asks, you have idli, why don't you have vada?
I remember you and your mom telling me, because I asked you the same thing. I asked, why are you doing only the idli? And the one thing that you said that point was that when you do one thing, you can do it really, really well.
Well, yeah.
So what happens to that philosophy now?
We continue to do that. So you do two things or you do three things, we do it. We still continue to do it well.
So your philosophy has changed a bit?
A bit, but not our, you know, service or not our quality. So that continues to remain the same. That continues to remain our utmost focus. That will never change. So yeah. Quality and affordability, two things, yes.
So the idlis are still at 10 rupees.
10 rupees, and the vadas are still priced at 10 rupees. So.
Oh, the vadas are 10 rupees.
Yes. So that's small size vada.
Small size.
Yeah, so everyone can afford and everyone can get to eat. So
is it a vada or a vadai?
So for Tamilians, it's called vadai. Okay, now that we are here in Karnataka, it's vada.
Because the idli here, of course, is more of the Tamil style here.
Tamil
because
style, yeah.
It's not the rice flour, but it's the rice hittu.
The rice hittu that we use.
That
yes.
They use. So, in fact, you should take a look at the Ayyar Idli episode that we did. I think that video has run over 1 million views, if I'm not mistaken.
1,173,000 something. So, I watch it every day. So
all right. That's fantastic. So, in fact, in that, Krishan has talked about the complete making of the idli. I think he's been very open, very transparent, talking about how that idli that has all of Vignan Nagar line up here every morning then, now of course even in the evening. So a lot of things have changed.
A lot of things have changed. I was working for an investment bank for the last 4 years. And you know, and I wanted to venture into this. This is a legacy that my dad left behind. So this is one memory that I have of him. So which I, you know, I didn't want to let go of it. So the last 3 months, I got married in between.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Really good thing that's happened to me. She's also helping me with the business now. So
it
was a decision that we took together.
That's how your mom could say, okay, now I can take a back seat.
Take a back seat,
yes. Somebody to help my son.
Yes.
What's your wife's name?
She's Karishma.
Karishma, okay.
So we've been dating for the last 5+ years.
Oh, okay.
So, I mean, we've grown together. And then, you know, we decided that yes, even she's quit her corporate job right before the wedding. So did I. So we took a conscious decision to run Ayyar Idli together.
Oh, nice.
Again, considering how the limitations that we have with the space here. So I have one more kitchen in the opposite building. That's where we make the vadas.
Okay. So the vadas are made there. What's this now? Now there's something addition here.
Yes.
Kora baat, kesari baat, chow chow baat.
Customers here would want us to try out idli or the vadas or the kara baat or the kesari baat, tea, coffee. At the end of the day, your customer is your king.
So where are you going to manage it? In the other kitchen?
Yeah, the other kitchen there. So the other kitchen is purely for cooking purposes. We'll bring it here and we'll start selling it. So the other kitchen is barely 30-40 meters away from here.
So basically that space that was dedicated to the idli here,
yes.
That doesn't change.
That will not change.
So you've added to the capacity.
Yes.
And so who's cooking that now? Well, so we have your mom,
yes,
and
so,
you of course.
Yeah. So we have two chefs now. Dedicated to make vada, kara baat and kesari baat.
So this is that special chutney, gatti chutney.
Yeah.
Making of the chutney, the idli, etc. We have spoken about at length in the Ayyar Idli video on Food Lovers TV. If you haven't caught it yet, I'm going to place a link up here and also in the description below.
The two grinders on the end is used for the udin vede or the urad dal. The one in the center, we keep it for rice.
So this is rice now?
This is rice, yeah. So this is the rice that is being ground.
This is
definitely idli rice.
Idli rice, yes.
Busy, busy idli. Higher idli. So all the coconut is gonna, that's gonna go into the chutney.
And these are for tomorrow morning.
Oh, okay.
The other one got 3 days and one.
So this is where the vades are made.
Yes. The vade batter consists of urad dal, then the rice flour for crispiness. Okay. Then to add to the taste, we add coriander leaves, we add curry leaves, we add black peppercorns, we add the jeera and some grated coconut. So yeah. He is the guy who makes vadas.
Vade master.
Yeah, he's the vade master. He's from Murdeshwar.
Murdeshwar, na? Yeah. Nice.
We use sunflower oil. The thing is, we fry the vade twice. That's something.
I think the size of your vade is a little compact.
It's compact, yeah. Most important thing is that idli is priced at 10, and vadas are, if they're priced at 10, it's easy for us to calculate.
So the vade is gone for the second dip. For the second dip in that hot oil, and that ensures the vade is crunchy. You know, you can make out by the sound that the vade makes when it hits that kadai. There's a different sound when the vade made the first time. It was almost muted. But now that vade is hitting that kadai with a certain aggression. And you know that the vade is crisp and crunchy. So this is where the vades are made. And Krishan is now going to take it to the shop there that you can see in the corner on the ground floor. So the vades are made up here and then transported rather quickly to the store. Fantastic. Married and he has somebody to help him also. Huh? I just saw upstairs. Shri Vedamurti Hampaya Swami Hira Mata
Hira Krupa Ashirvada Hira Mata
Hira Mata Hosa Hosa Alli
Yen
Martira Nivu Illi
Na Bonda Bajji
Bonda Bajji North Karnataka Sir Elli Ure Elli
Nam Taluk Jilla Raichur
Raichur Inda Spicy Irute
Ograni Mirchi
Ograni Mirchi Ella Martira. So that is N Narasana Gowda, and I'm told you should run a very popular push cart here doing the vade bajji
bajji
Bonda. And now he's got a store coming up. So the store is under renovation. So I can't taste it here today, but maybe some other day.
Only veg.
So the next time you're here at Vignan Nagar, you can do a combo. You can do the idli at Iyer Idli, and you can do the bajji with Mr. Gowda. Good luck. All the very best. Thank you very much. Well, I've got my idli vade here. I think I'm going to make a beginning with the idli. This is the Iyer idli. It's the sort of idli that breaks under its own weight. That's how soft and fluffy this idli is. Of course, I've done a detailed review on Iyer idli in an episode on Food Lovers TV. This is more about the vade, but then I want to taste the idli before you taste the vade, because once you taste the vade, you cannot really taste the idli. That idli is just the way I remember it. It's a bit porous. It's soft. And a bit pasty, because out here they do the idlis in the Tamil Nadu style. So it's not made with a rice rubber, but with a rice batter. So the texture of this idli is slightly pasty. And there's also a hint of tartness. A hint of tartness that you taste in the idli at the very end. That comes from the fermentation of the batter. Let's go for that idli with some of that chutney. The chutney has plenty of kai or the coconut, and then also a bit of the urukatle, the roasted gram. That's a component of chutneys here typically. Next, it's time to go for the vadai. And what I like here is a pricing philosophy of the vadai. So the idli is priced at rupees 10, the vadai too is priced at rupees 10, because they don't want to make life too complicated. So when they're counting, when they have to calculate how many idlis, vadais one has had, it's basically the same unit, rupees 10.
And therefore, of course, the vade is also slightly smaller. It's probably half the size of a vade that you will find in a typical darshini or sort. So the vade is half in size. But then who cares if the taste of the vade is special? This vade is warm, a bit gari gari, so it's got the crunch that you taste. And of course, the vades are typically fried twice, and that helps in the crispy crunch of the vade. You got a bit of green chili in there, you got some, perhaps some coriander, you got a sliver of coconut in there as well. So this is a vade that's flavorful, has a bit of a crispy crunch as you bite into it. On the inside, the vade has a bit of a weight. I just bit into some pepper there in that vade.
Hot vade.
Fantastic.
It's extremely hot.
So I've got a really, really hot vadai. So hot that I can barely hold it. Let me go back to my warm vadai. Allowing for that vadai to cool down just for a few seconds more. This is not a vadai that goes crunch, crunch, crunch from the beginning to the end. There is a bit of a crunch as you bite it. And then you have the flavor of the pepper. I think there's some cumin in there somewhere. You bite into slivers of coconut. There's some green chili as well. And also a tinge of salt that I'm tasting in that vadai. But let's say that vadai is piping hot. Started with some green chilies there. You can see the black pepper too. That's revealing itself from within the crunchy texture of that vadai. So I think the texture of the vadai here mimics the idli slightly. Not in terms of the crispiness. Of course, the vadai is crispy, the idli is not. As you bite into the vadai, that vade has a bit of a weight. I think I just bit into some curry leaf there. What I like most about this vade is the crunch of the vade. That to me is the most special. Let me try and see if I can get some chutney. Well, I got some more chutney, and this is the telu chutney this time. The last time around was a combination of the gatti chutney and the telu chutney. This time it's only the telu chutney. So what I like most about this vade is its crisp, crunchy bite. I like the fact that every bite rewards you with a lot of flavor. Whether it's the pepper, a bit of the green chili, some of the cumin, some curry leaves as well. And the second thing that I like about the vade is its size. It's compact, so you can easily make a meal of two or three idlis and a couple of vades at least. And therefore, also the price at 10 rupees an idli and 10 rupees a vade. Let's go back to that idli now. I'm going to taste it this time with a bit of that gunpowder. It's basically lentils, some spices. I think a fair bit of red chili powder. I think there's also some asafoetida that I taste in there somewhere. It's a spicy powder. The idli today has a vade for company, and by the time you watch this episode, you'll probably have a few more items in the menu. I think there's a kesari bath and the kara bath, etc., that will also follow. But I think when I compare the idli to the vade, it's the idli and that idli chutney combination that still wins. I think that vade, or the vade as we call it here in Karnataka, makes for a nice accompaniment to that idli.
Karishma,
the boss. Hi, how are you?
Hello.
I have two idlis and two vadas. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Kripal.
Thank you for the food. I did. For me, the idli is what will bring me. And the vada is a nice companion to the idli.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I'll see you.
Cheers. Happy eating. Take care.
See you. Well, I enjoyed my evening out at Ayer Idli. That idli still is what will bring me back. That vadai makes for a nice, flavorful companion to the idli. But if you need one reason to visit Ayer Idli, it's definitely the idli, as it resonates in the name. So you want to taste idli, but taste an idli that's made with a whole lot of love, with a whole lot of attention, a whole lot of care by a family that's been devoted to this for the last two decades. Well, definitely check out Ayer Idli. And now to give that idli company, they have that vadai. And by the time you watch this video, they would also have the khara bath and the kesari bath and also some coffee too. So I hope you enjoyed this very quick tasting Short City ride. Until the next time, take care. See you. Bye-bye.